الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد, the Muslim is always trying to increase his or her faith, increase their iman, because iman, it fluctuates. Sometimes a person has strong faith and sometimes a person's faith is weak. So we should always strive to do those things which can increase our faith and make us stronger believers in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in an authentic hadith that was collected in that's in Bukhari and Muslim, and also in Ibn Hibban wa Ahmad. Qala alayhi salatu wasalam, thalith man kun fihi wajid bihinna halawat al-iman. He said that three people, that if they find these characteristics in their self, they have tasted the sweetness of faith. And yakun Allah wa rasuluhu uhibba ilayhi mimma siwahima. The first thing he said is that to the person that they love Allah and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than anything else or anyone else. So the first way that they show that they have tasted faith, the beauty of faith, is that they love the Prophet, they love Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than they love their self and more than they love everything. وَقَالَ صَلَى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. So the second thing, وَأَنْ يَحَبَّ الْمَرْءِ لَا يُحَبُّهُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ. And the second thing is that the person who has tasted faith loves a person strictly for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That for no other reason, they love them because this person has strong faith. That they see that person and they love him or her for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because they see them doing obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not for something in the world. They don't love them, oh, he's my family member, or they love him for the sake that he has a lot of money, or he or she has a nice car, she's a very beautiful woman, I love her for this sake. No, they love this person only for the sake of Allah, meaning that they love them, that for this is a part of iman. They love them for their faith, because they see that this person has the characteristics of a believer. And the third thing, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, وَأَنْ يَقْرَهُ أَنْ يَعُودَ فِي الْكُفْرِ بَعْدَ أَنْ أَنْكَذَهُ اللَّهُ مِنْهُ كَمَا يَقْرَهُ أَنْ يَقْذَفَ فِي النَّارِ. The third thing that shows that a person has tasted the sweetness of faith is that they hate to return to disbelief after Allah has guided them to Islam. So see, for you guys were born Muslim, alhamdulillah, and still you should hate to become other than a Muslim. You should have a love to be a Muslim. But for myself, because I didn't grow up being a Muslim, I've tasted disbelief and I've tasted the life of belief. So the person who dislikes going back to the life of disbelief, as much as he hates to be thrown into the hellfire, then this person has tasted the sweetness of faith. They've tasted the halawat al-iman. That's what we all want to strive to have and taste faith, that we should love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should strive to love. If you see someone, you love them strictly for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's a good sign, a sign of strong iman. And that you hate to go to disbelief, that's a song of strong iman and faith. And that you love Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than you love anything, more than you love your own desires. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us to be of those who taste the halawat al-iman. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi وسلم.